This could be a bag of fun. What is it? An LTD 8-string bass guitar. It's never really seen much love. Let's just see what can happen. We're getting new strings. That'll be the best love it's gotten in a long time. It looks pretty grubby, but still. Nothing ain't gonna sound like that. I've got it all tuned up, and it's like... straightness we got. It's a monster, but I would never be seen playing this, but in the recording studio I will be needing to borrow this from my friend Duncan, because once I dial this in, it is going to be a tone monster that the kids will never figure out how you did it, right? How'd they do that? I sort of detected a couple of high frets up here, but you know, we'll get there when we get there. And what's it doing? It needs to be straightened out a little bit, but not much. Let's just make sure it works. And the string gauges that are going on are a little different than what's on here, but we're gonna be okay. So yeah, it just makes me want to write a song. So cool.
Once again, truss rod hole inspection. I think we better blow some dirt out of there before we even look.
For sure, I am the first human in there. And it looks like a little tiny, weeny little 4 mil hidden down in there. You know, we don't want to be the guy that racks it, right? Leave that to the guy who owns it. Can we find it? I got it. Okay, so I got the T-handle out here. And I really just want to see if this will loosen. Oh, it's tight as tight could be, but it's moving. It's moving. I don't know if it's going to want to tighten for me, but it does move, so... we'll do the best we can with what we have. We'll have to wait and see. Get all the old strings off, clean this up, and start over. Always being mindful for stuff like that. Right? Alrighty. More things to think about. Once again, before I get all sex-cited, see, now that the strings are off it, the neck is pretty straight. I really just want to make sure this works right. And I'm going to just try loosening it off a lot. Just get it to turn. Maybe I should just take it right out. That's probably not a good idea. There's a lot of goo in there. Oh, it's one of those. It's gooed in. We're not doing that. We can hear it creaking. No, it's tensioning. This thing really needs a good cleanup anyway. But, while I'm doing that. Yeah, that's straight, but no strings. All right, now we got to add 8 million pounds of PSI to this. Let's clean it all up. I want to have a look at this bridge because someone said it didn't go up and down, and I know that it does. Then we're going to put on these brand new strings, which I think are going to be way better than what was on it. I'm certain of that.
So as discovered, the bridge was all the way to the bottom, but it does go down. It is a bolt-on. We're going to put a little bit of a shim in here before we even begin because this was all the way down and it played like ass. Oh, did I say that word? Not Disney friendly. Inspected in the USA. I think all they inspected was the paint job because it didn't play very nice. You see, I'm not the first guy. Once again, they used the sandpaper shim. I'm going to get that out of there and bump that up a bit and put it across. Guys thinking. Okay, so I'm going with 22 thou of hardwood veneer right across the back. Now a little piece over here. Something to try.
Okay, the bridge is to the deck. I put a shim in the neck. What I would like to see is for this to just crest the top of those bridge saddles. And that is absolutely amazing. What a guesstimation. That's gonna play good now. So, what would I do next? Clean all my grubby paw prints off it. And on something like this, I start with the heavy course of strings, right? And you see how these saddle adjustments are. The other string has to follow the other string. So we'll start with the heavy course of strings first. Set up the guitar with those, and then we'll add the skinny ones. It's going to be cool. I just can't wait to hear this in the studio. I think it's going to be awesome.
Okay, so as mentioned, I have the heavy course of strings installed, and I'm going to just begin to tweak the neck a little bit, and we will set some string height best we can. We don't have individual string height adjustment here, so we may have to get some files out to actually get this right, but we'll find out. So let's just get the four fat strings working, and then we're going to add the skinny strings. And once again, too, the intonation is dictated by a single saddle. So we'll do the fat strings, the octave strings will be what they will be.
Okay, so I did overcompensate a little bit with the neck relief, just because I know I have four more strings to apply. But let's just see, you know, this is all close but no cigars, because we got to check it all again when we get everything together. But what do we got for string height? And the string height is, wow, almost right where I'd like to see it, but we have to check every string. So we're just above five. At five, way too low at, so we gotta raise the whole bridge. Let's see what happens when I do that. So now, we'll attempt to do intonation with the heavy course of strings. String height seems nice, but that's right on. Very close, not going to touch it. One more time. Slightly flat. A string slightly flat as well. String all over it.
Okay, let's fix that up. Okay, that's fairly rock and roll. Thank you, Daddy Dario, for making the ball ends the same color for the octave strings as for the fat strings. I love you guys. That's a head scratcher that's right out of the way.
As I'm adding the strings,
I'm adding more string tension. And I want to keep checking the neck relief. So right now I need to give that another spin. Couple more strings and we'll be 8 stringing. But what I've learned about this bridge is that the balls, my balls, have to be sight by each or they don't work. So I have to loosen the string and get those to sit side by each other.
Hey, once again, we got all 8 strings on it. Revisit that truss rod. I'm loving the string height. And we need a little twist, but hey, we're getting there. A little bit at a time, right? Don't want to shock the thing.
Well, I did enough truss rod cranking for tonight. We'll let it sit, but pickups were way too close to the strings. That's okay. This could probably come up a snuggle, but everything was choking. I'm gonna do a little demo of this in a minute, and then I'm just, I need one of these. It's like a songwriting machine. For me, anyway. That guy's gotta come up on that side. Like I said, I'm a little concerned about the neck straightness. The truss rod is really, really cranked tight right now, and I tried to help it out on the bench as well, pushing it mechanically. We'll see what happens. That guy ended up too close. Everybody's having a good time. This thing sounds awesome, I just gotta say. Like, even through my crappy little bench amp, this thing rings like a bell. What's going on with that? What is going on with that and why? That one needs to come up too. I'll be back in a moment. Okay, once again, I'm gonna walk away. Sit down to play this, get my hands around it, but oh, I'd love to try it with a pick. Oh, and there's all kinds of boost things here, like wow. Folks, thanks for hanging out. This is an LTD 8-string thing. I don't know, is there a model Indonesia something other serial number? Anyway, one more time, just want to check this string height. Just while I got you here, because it just seems weird, but it's because you're pushing so many strings. Maybe I can cheat it down a bit so that it even feels better. Yeah, see, it creeped up on me, so we're going to drop that down. That's something we'll do, but like I said, I want to let this sit. I had all the strings off it. I cranked the hell out of the truss rod. Sometimes things take time. Anyway, thanks for hanging out. All the links for things are below. Special shout out to all my patrons, subscribers, Facebook followers, Twitter tweeters, and everybody in between. Be good to each other. Cheers.